Hey folks, I thought I'd send you a video since it's hard to see the 3D effects when looking at the static images printed on a PDF file. This is made from the GoPro pictures that Elizabeth sent me, which I guess were taken by the camera rather than using the software to extract from the video the individual stills. And it looked to me like those stills taken by the camera were higher resolution than what's extracted, but not too bad. And made some progress here. This is looking down at the final 3D model. Now you might recall that from the set of photos that we were missing the lower ring. So this is just the upper tiers, as it were. And what I'm going to do now is to rotate the image. And here we go, the model. And you can see that there's definitely a three-dimensional component to this. There's the vegetation. Now, without the bottom rung, we can't see behind the tape or behind certain objects because it only came down from the top. We did look inside it, though, for example. So if we went like around here, you can see that we zoomed inside. There's the label, and I'm not sure what it says, but it's not too bad. Now, this is medium resolution because, again, I didn't really want the computer to be running for many, many hours. The use of these objects here, the marker pen and the tape and the glove and so forth, I think really speeded up the process. It made sorting the images a lot faster, even without my having to go in and manually declare these as markers in the software, which you can do. You can actually flag these as markers and tell the computer to pay attention to it. I also, in the sparse point cloud, as it's called, eliminated any of the points that were looking off into the background. And so that speeded up the process as well because I wasn't paying attention to the background. But then, I don't know why it hadn't occurred to me, but of course there is this bar that goes across the image. And the problem with that is that the bar is static. And because the bar is static, but everything else is moving, the software gets confused by it. Didn't do too bad. You can see here, right here, that it understood that this basal part here did not move. When you get the fuzziness and sometimes a sort of white sheen, like these white specks out here, I think that's caused by the fact that the bar is static while everything else is moving. And that doesn't make sense to the camera. It assumes that if you moved, everything else should have moved as well. But that's not the case here. Now there's a feature which can allow you to mask the object that is static, and then remove that from the each of the photos. I've been trying to avoid having to go in and manually massage all of the photos because I just feel that that's going to take a lot of time. But then there will have to be some processing that we are doing at some point. Let's take a look at that mark. There's a small plant there. Here's the marker. So you can see at a small number of faces that I think this is medium resolution. It's not as high. But then on the other hand, if you're just trying to estimate the volume of the vegetation and not try to identify species or read the labels on the junk that's inside the marker, it does a pretty good job. This is missing one of the rings. So I'll try again with the other rings. There's that pen again. See if we can get a more complete picture. But this is looking pretty good to me, and I think once I learn how to do masking, I can remove this sort of a halo effect that's being caused by the static white frame. And I mean the bar that comes down and rolls across the top. And get more and more emphasis on just what's inside the ring and trim away all the rest of this stuff on the outside. And I think that, with the PRI and with the thermal infrared, which I hope you'll be able to do, we'll be able to get some pretty beautiful associations between the structure of this vegetation and some of the ecophysiological measurements of the vegetation itself. That's it. I'll post this on YouTube.